Well, shalom, ladies and gentlemen. This is Kazoo Cruiser, and I'm still at the prototype lab, and it occurred to me to talk about this. This is series number three in the series. While we're working feverishly on this side of the equation to fix the pyramid, we've got prototypes of stuff that we can put together, and this is a good way. Now, we know we've already talked about putting the pigs into Syria, but we've got to guard our little piggy friends, too. So we need to come up with a coat of mail, and I've got a good idea for that, but I don't have those kind of prototyping materials. Here in the shop, it's a chain mail. You know, like we had to send a little gladiators in with chain mail against the bad guys. We just had superior technology, and they were misusing it, of course. So what we do is we make a little chain mail, and we put a little Porker in it, and we send it in. You know, he doesn't need a helmet. He's got a pretty hard head, and he's just intent. You know, when the whole thing fell, I think what happened is they got popped up. There were earthworms, and they got popped up, okay? And they walk around like little worms with legs. You know, they don't like the filth, but they'll roll around in it. It cools them off, okay? So we keep them hydrated, and we keep them cool, and because the way this thing is bad resonance, it'll just make them mad because they don't like to wear a collar. And a chainmail suit has its own advantages in deflecting firearms and rocks that they don't want to get hit by anyway. So it would just make them pretty much bulletproof. And we fit them, and that's another American industry. And the beautiful thing is, it'll kind of make them mad, like a bad radio signal would make you kind of mad. Dropping the toaster while it's plugged in the bathtub would probably do something to make you mad, too. So just wearing the metal creates an ambience that they pick up, and it's a bad way to deal with things. But if we put them in that little armor suit, they'll be bulletproof. And, you know, won't they look fun looking at the sky? We'll see all that bright, you know, stuff, and the cameras are there. But we have another issue here, and it's President Obama needs to be aware of not just this, but the rain. If it's a nice day, everybody's out there with the cameras. That's one set of security risks. But pay attention from this perspective. There's an entirely new risk presented by rain if it rains all over the Golden Heights parade. So what we need is to make sure that people basically get stripped down to nothing and then walk through a metal detector. Because if they're all subjected equally to that same indignity, none of you is going to complain, okay? Anybody slipping through the crowd with a bayonet or a plastic knife or a ceramic knife or even a broken CD, a CD can be broken and used as a weapon, okay? It minimizes the impact. But the fact is that they can get that in, they can get something else in. And we got to protect the guy that's carrying the message here. You know, he might want to retire there in Syria after his job here in the United States is done. So he's auditioning, and we'll find somebody else that doesn't mind being as happy as a pig and slop if he's not interested in picking up a shovel or a wood stave. And I don't want him carrying anything metal. Okay, I want him going in there barefoot. And he can take the same bath first that all those Syrian kids are to show them that it's safe to swim. You do know how to swim, don't you, Mr. President? Do you know how to swim? Do you know how to surf? Do you know how to do a wheelie on a motorcycle? Well, the best two out of three wins, and we want to save everybody from everybody. And let's send the pigs in with little chain mail. They'll look fine, okay? They'll look fun, and we just need to prototype that out, but I don't have a pig that happened to be around here. And we don't have them in Syria yet, so let's move them into Syria, and then let's stand back and see the things that the author of the rainbow can do when he's in control instead of you or I or somebody who's not in the pyramid right now. Shalom, this is Kazoo Cruiser, and that's a mock-up too, folks. Just pay attention in class, okay?